Thank you. Yeah. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Good morning on this fourth Sunday of Advent. Today, of course, we mark the final Sunday in the Lenten journey in preparation to celebrate the coming of Jesus. Now, this is probably going to be the shortest fourth week in Advent ever, maybe about 6 hours. And of course, tonight is Christmas Eve. So a special welcome to those who are visiting us today. Welcome to those who plan on visiting us this evening, and of course, tomorrow. Let's pray for our visitors, and let's be sensitive to their needs. Let's begin as we pray together, calling for purity. Almighty God,
to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you, and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Congregation, please be seated, and the family leading us in the lighting of the curtain. Come on.
To remind us that God is love. We thank him for the love that he gives us and shows us the way. Let us pray. O God of love, send your light into our hearts. Grant that we may so dwell in Christ that his perfect love fills our entire being. May our worship be the time in which we celebrate your love and are made ready to show that love to the whole world. Amen.
Thank you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, who chose the Virgin Mary, full of grace, to be the mother of our Lord and Savior, now fill us with your grace, that we in all things may embrace your will and with her rejoice in your salvation. Through Jesus Christ the Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
When the king was dwelling in his house, and the Lord had given him rest from all his enemies around, that the king said to Nathan the prophet, "See now, I dwell in a house of cedar, but the ark of God dwells inside tent curtains." Then Nathan said to the king, "Go, do all that is in your heart, for the Lord is with you." But it happened that night that the word of the Lord came to Nathan, saying, "Go tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, would you build a house for me to dwell in? For I have not dwelt in a house since the time that I brought the children of Israel up from Egypt, even to this day. But you moved me about in a tent and in a tabernacle. Wherever I moved about with all the children of Israel, have I ever spoken a word to anyone from the tribes of Israel, whom I commanded to shepherd my people Israel, saying, why have you not built me a house of cedar? Now therefore, thus shall you say to my servant David, thus says the Lord of hosts, I took you from the sheepfold, from following the sheep, to be a ruler over my people in Israel. Have I been with you wherever you've gone, and have cut off all the enemies before you, and have made you a great name, like the name of the great men who are on the earth? Moreover, I will appoint a place for my people, Israel, and plant them, that they may dwell in a place of their own, and move no more. Nor shall the sons of wickedness oppress them any more, as previously. Since the time I have commanded judges to be over my people, Israel, and have caused you to rest from all your enemies. Also, the Lord tells you that he will make you a house. And your house and your kingdom shall be established forever before you. Your throne shall be established forever." The word of the Lord. The second reading is from the book of Romans, chapter 16, verses 25 to 27. May God receive glory. He is able to strengthen your faith. He does this in keeping with the good news and the message that I preach. It is the message about Jesus Christ. This message is in keeping with the mystery in a very long time. The mystery has now been made known to the writings of the prophets. The eternal God commanded that it be made known. God wanted all the Gentiles to obey him by trusting in him. May the only wise God receive glory forever through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
our Lord Jesus Christ, according to you.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, the gifts, of course, that we exchange at Christmas are really only symbolic of, well, what we will attain and what we will receive. Because the gift of God, of course, is the birth of Jesus. Now, many of us here today are pretty well fed. At least I can speak well for myself. And many of us have all that we need. we may be looking for something as well. I saw on Facebook, actually, on Friday, attention men, today you should start shopping for Christmas. Or at least thinking about it. So much of our hopes and our aspirations, right, can happen around Christmas. In fact, we're told, and we know this to be true, that Christmas can be a difficult time for many people. Perhaps because of the subtext of expectation around Christmas. Christmas highlights where we are at times on our journey. Perhaps we may be in a season of loss, maybe even in a season of grief. And Christmas can highlight that as well. Oh, but our deepest need, indeed, is for something more, isn't it? And so we gather, and so we will gather tonight with that wonderful, wonderful, abiding need of hope with us. Yes, indeed. Gifts under the tree can be fine, but the gifts of God for the people of God, indeed, are what truly saves. And Jesus, the only begotten Son of God, is the Savior of the world. Jesus comes to us, my friends, when we least expect him. Sometimes when we're struggling, sometimes when we're experiencing grief, and sometimes when life is not going as well as we would hope it to be. The author of the Book of Psalms reminds us God is close to the brokenhearted. Jesus comes in our need, in our time and place. We have that wonderful story, of course, this morning, the Annunciation. Imagine the Annunciation and the Incarnation happening within the same 24-hour period. Those are the two things that are like dark. God comes to us when we least expect him. And from the fullness of Jesus, we receive grace upon grace. God's fullness, a heart overflowing with love for all people, a heart so filled that it would not stand to be apart from us, but would come to us. Even though we humans are the ones that do cause the breach between ourselves and God, God never, ever, ever stands aloof, always close to us, always willing to come to our need. See, Jesus is the living word, the one who gives us life, the one who gives us meaning and purpose, the one who gives us encouragement, and indeed, at the end of our earthly lives, gives us eternal life. This word is made present for us in our lives, here and now, through the waters of baptism, and in the bread and wine of the Holy Eucharist. The Word made flesh does come among us and affects his purposes for us. You know, and Jesus, of course, acts through all the acts of compassion of the church. You know? When we visit somebody in the nursing home, when we see somebody at their sick bed, when we encourage somebody who's struggling, Jesus is always present. So what are you hoping for this Christmas? Is it going to be under the tree? Tonight? Or tomorrow? Or whenever you exchange gifts? Do you think it's concrete or tangible? Yes, it is. The Word made flesh dwelt among us, full of grace and truth, to give us eternal gifts, eternal life, now and in the life to come. So wherever you may be, in your loneliness, your hunger, your fear, Jesus calls with outstretched arms. He is the life, you see, the light of all people. He is the true life, He breaks all oppression. He sets captives free. He is the Word made flesh who dwells among us. So tonight, as we welcome all sorts of visitors, as we welcome people who may not have been here for a while, we remember that they are God's special guests. We remember that God has been working in their lives as it went ours and has brought them here for a moment of grace. And we pray for them as we pray for ourselves, that we'd be open to receive. Because Jesus has come, my friend, and is coming, and will come again. Let's pray. Blessed Lord, we thank you for the holy mystery of the Incarnation, that you came among us in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, that you were born among us, and that you journeyed with us, and that you taught us by the example of your life. More especially, Lord, we thank you that you offered yourself the one full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. And then through you, we have your eternal gifts. Bless your people gathered before you, and those who will come in the next 24 hours, that they may hear and receive what you have for them today. For we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Confess the faith of our baptism as we say.
I believe in God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered in the Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day he rose again.
Join together in our communal prayers. Let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, hear our prayer. We remember, O God, all those who are in our congregation who are in physical or spiritual need, and ask for healing and support in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for the soul of Joanne Breer and Mary Muncie, long-time parishioners of our church. And we also pray for strength and peace and understanding for their bereaved family. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our rector, Byron Gilmore, and his family as they bravely make their transition into retirement life. And he looks for new opportunities for service. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for your guidance and wisdom for the selection committee as they meet with prospective candidates
to find the right person to be the servant leader of this church in the years ahead. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for all those who serve as volunteers in different areas, such as the choir, greeters, readers, altar guild, and the coffee hour helpers, because they provide the glue that cements our relationships with each other. Lord, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
May we, by our thoughts and our deeds, welcome strangers into our church and be what we proclaim to be, a caring Christian community serving others in the power of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And all this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners and invites us to his table. Let's confess our sins then, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God,
we confess our sins to you,
I'm here.
Let us pray. God of hope, renew us in the joy of your salvation, and make us a living sacrifice to you. This we ask for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now we watch for the day when he will come again in power and great triumph to judge this world, that we, without shame or fear, may rejoice to behold his appearance. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Therefore, Father, according to his command, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, Lord, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son and his sacrifice, that we, made acceptable in him, may be sanctified by your Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ, and make them new, and bring us to that city of light, where you dwell with all your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation, by him, wisdom and means. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, please. Thank you. faithful girl. In this sacrament, we receive the promise of salvation. May we, like the Blessed Virgin Mary, be obedient to your will. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Whose power in us, in the name of the Lord, in us for abundance. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the Church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen.
Just a couple things to highlight. Of course, our Christmas Eve service this evening is at 7 p.m. and on Christmas Day at 10 a.m. There'll be carols immediately before the service in both instances. And just two things. I've been asked for you tonight, or tomorrow. When you come nice and early, and you know where to park, please park there and leave the closer spots to the church for visitors. And when you come really early to church and you want to sit at the back, don't. Because that's where the visitors come at the last minute because they haven't found a parking spot or want to sit, because they want to actually see and follow what the congregation does. But invariably what happens every year is the visitors have to sit in the front pews. So let's not do that. If we need to sit at the back, please do so. There's lots of people who should, right? And if you've got any sort of physical challenges, please do so. But if you don't have to, it's a little cold back there and you can't hear anyway, right? So come on up, I promise I won't eat you. Speaking of eating, we have a splendid, sumptuous coffee hour left. I have no idea, there's lots of food. So come on down, don't anybody go home hungry. Come on down for a time of fellowship at coffee hour downstairs. I believe that's all our announcements. I'm going to say a few hours early. Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Would you bow your heads? Now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Thank you.
grace has ended, our service now begins. Go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.